Let's say I love the way Moses Simon Ekpa, or the Prime Minister of Biafra Republic of Israel, used to answer questions. They asked him a question that borders on the religion, because before now, Simon Ekpa said that when Biafra come, we'll have only three religion that is recognized, official religion, official. He used the word official. And those religion that will be recognized officially in Biafra land will be Christianity, number one, number two is Judaism, and number three, we say tradition religion. So this trader, so this guy asked him, does he mean that Islam will not be welcome in Biafra land? Hear the way he answered the question. And the other one also went ahead to ask a question. He said, you call yourself the disciple of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu that has been in incarceration for, and don't you think that he will be disappointed when he comes out? And just disappointed in the sense that you are also, you know, agitating for the freedom of Biafra, but not under IPOB. Listen to the way he also addressed that question. And please share this video.
Thank you, Dr. Man. Good evening, Simon. Mine is just clarification. It's a follow-up to... Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Yeah, it's a follow-up to Okija and Okija question. You referenced three religion officially recognized in Biafra State. You live in Finland, and Finland's constitution guarantees freedom of religion and freedom of conscience. 0.4% of the population have official membership. Is it the case that they will practice Islam in Biafra if it ever happens, but will not be officially recognized? Or is it the case that Muslims will not be allowed in Biafra? Just clarification, please.
Thank you very much. We are going to sign into law the United Nations Treaty that protects every person, both religious person, both minority group. So those laws will be signed in sent into law in our local law constitution, and it will be respected. So, but what I'm telling you is that the official religion remain Christianity, Jewish, and traditional religion. This is official that we have in Biafra territory. And just like you go to Saudi Arabia today, you don't go there to question the laws while they are very hostile to some certain religion and all that. So we are going to have that in Biafra land, but we are going to respect international laws.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Mr. Rudolph. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Mr. Rudolph, good evening, sir. Mazi Simon Ekpa, the Prime Minister of Biafra. Yeah. Thank you. And I greet everyone in the panel. I have two questions to ask you, the Prime Minister, and then I will ask it in one. The sit at home is only being done in 5 eastern part of Nigeria. But as we are told, the Biafra constitutes the old eastern region. So the people from River State, the people from Delta, the people from Calabas, they are not doing it at home. The people from Kogi, they are not doing it at home. So I want to know why those people are not doing it at home. Is it only Igbo people that is Biafra? I want you to clarify that. And then the second question I want to ask you, I was listening to you. You made mention of the leader of Indigenous people of Biafra, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, is to call yourself his disciple. I want to know, wouldn't that be so much disrespectful to him when he eventually come out tomorrow?
Say it again, I didn't hear you well.
Okay, I say you made mention that, like, I mean, that you are still loyal to him, that you are still his disciple.
Yes.
So I want to ask you, wouldn't that be so much disrespectful to him if he eventually come out tomorrow? And then, I mean, because like the government in Israel, I think, is quite different from the group he's leading. So I want you also to clarify me the difference between IPOB and the government in Israel. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Let me ask you a question. Is Mazi Nnamdi Kanu agitating for a group or for a country?
Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is agitating for the restoration of Biafra.
What am I agitating for?
You're also agitating for an sovereign independent state of Biafra.
So, and you think Mazi Nnamdi Kanu will come out and be interested in agitating to restore IPOB as a group?
When Nnamdi Kanu come out, who is going to be a leader?
It is not about who is going to be a leader. I think he's going to be very, very proud of how far we have gone, because his admiration, his aspiration and dream did not die. So as a leader that he is, he already is coming with Biafra. I told people that Mazinam Nkanu will come out in a historic way. Biafra will be the restoration of Biafra. Listen, let me answer you. The restoration of Biafra will be declared and the document will be generated. Mazinam Nkanu said severally, when he was being asked, when are you going to declare Biafra? He said, people of Biafra have not given him mandate. He was asked again by this Rudolph here that when is he going to start engaging the United States? He responded, which the video I watched in the beginning of this program, he responded that the people have not sent him to go to the United States. Well, right, Rudolph, if I'm wrong, that was what he said here. So here today, the people of Biafra have given me mandate and given the Biafra government mandate. And he's part of it. So if he come and distance himself, that's a different thing. But for the fact that he's fighting for Biafra, and because of Biafra, he's being incarcerated, I believe he should be proud of how far we have got today, within 2 years. Within 2 years, we have been to that America under the mandate of the Biafra people, 50 million people of Biafra given to us. Where for the past 8 years, or before he was granted that interview, I don't know which year was that, but at least he said that the Biafra people have not given him the mandate. And that was the early stage. So today, over 50 million has given us the mandate. And that's why we are engaging the United States officially. That's why we're having this convention officially. That's why dignitaries from around the world will come to Finland for this. But if you don't know that, you know it now. That are going to be dignitaries, they're going to be policymakers that will come to this convention. And it's going to be live. So everybody will see them and know who they are.
Okay.